we have to answer a lot of questions regarding impressions. So they ask you, what do you do? Do you do makeovers? Are you a beautician? I say we do much more than that. Because we fix people's images inside out. You know, you are only confident on the outside when you've done a lot of repair or the engineering work from inside. So when we talk about impressions, it's just not about clothing, grooming, body language, and etiquette. You come across as a whole new package to a person who's standing in front of you. It's like a package which can be taken home. So let's discover a new thing about impressions and let's break stereotypes today, right? So, now which building would give you a better rent?
The one on the right.
Absolutely. The white one, right? Very simple question, you'll be able to guess that. Now, you are a successful businessman or an entrepreneur. You need to have a driver to drive your wife or a chauffeur to drive your wife and drive your daughter. Who do you think would be your choice? Obvious. I'll ask you obvious questions only because I want you to come to my point. Obviously the first one, why not the second one? Probably he might take your wife and daughter away, elope with them.
He could break it.
Yeah, he could elope with your daughter.
That I don't know, but of course he can be reacted.
So he could just pick your, so as a father, I would want to make sure that my daughter and my wife is safe with the chauffeur. The first one looks pretty decent, although he might not be, but my first impression is of a person who's very, very decent. My wife and my daughter would be safe, right? Let's look at this. You're going to be joining your husband for a corporate event. It's a very serious event, and you've got to create an impression of a person who's serious. You're going to be dressed up like the first one or the second one? Obviously, right? Very, very, very simple questions and very simple answers. But what did we just do?
Stereotypes.
What did we just do?
Stereotypes.
No, didn't we all form an impression about them by just looking at pictures?
We analyzed.
We analyzed. We just looked at them and we formed an impression.
Is it fair?
I'll come back to that. I'll come back to that. It's not fair, but I'll come back to that. So what exactly are impressions? Impressions are our reactions and responses to people and situation in general. You know, we form impressions every single day by just looking at people, by just looking at the situations. If you really look at the first picture, by just looking at that person, you know that he's a clown, right? By looking at the second picture, it's a picture about maybe you'll say India, overpopulated, right? And the third one obviously is a good-looking man who's striking a pose, right? There's a bomb here in the mic, so we bear up with that. We call it a bomb in our training with the corporates, like whenever something like this happens, there's a bomb there, so we bear up with it. So third picture, we form an impression about a lady who's a model, right? So impressions are formed within, I would say, 3 to 7 seconds of meeting a person. And most of these impressions are, sorry to say, everlasting. Because life doesn't give us the second chance to meet a person. In most of the social scenes and professional scenarios, we get to meet a person only for the few seconds and we form impression about that person and take it back home. Sorry, but it happens like this. There's a science behind it and we are going to reveal that now. So impressions are formed within 7 seconds, as you say. So you must have formed an impression about me when I entered this place. Most of you don't know me, but you did form an impression about me. By the way I smile, by the way I walk, by the way I strike a conversation, by the way I make an eye contact with each one of you here, right? Now let's look into how are impressions formed and why are they formed? Impression is very, very contextual. And there are 3 ingredients based here which help you form an impression. It's between you, the stranger, and the situation. There are three people, there are three ingredients in creating that recipe of first impression. It's me, it's the stranger, and the situation. Now here, everything depends upon the situation. Like, I've come here today for a function to address you people, wonderful, beautiful ladies, warm and affectionate. I form an impression, take a thin slice of it and go back home. So the situation is a meeting and I form an impression, right, out of it. I'm not able to kind of have a conversation with you here, a long conversation. I just take a thin slice of each one of you back home. So every impression is contextual, wherein you meet a stranger, you are in a situation and you form an impression out of it. And again, it depends upon what the stranger is expecting from you, his experiences, his education, his qualification, what he expects at that point of view in that particular situation from you, his background, his conditioning. There are so many things. And the last thing to the whole thing is you. So the most valuable asset to the whole thing is you. How do you take that back home? What kind of an impression do you form about a particular person when you meet, or a particular situation, or a particular professional scenario, or a particular event? Say, for example, you might be looking for alliance for your sons and daughters at this point of time, right? A father, he's a military person. And the girl comes and approaches the father and she says, I'm in love with this guitarist. And the father says, no, this is against my family tradition. How can you get married to a guitarist? Because you need to get married to a military person. She says, but I'm in love with him. He says, okay, call that man home. The man comes home. The boy comes home. The father sits there in his coat with a glass of wine. And the father says, looks at him, he's not groomed well. He's a pianist and he's got his hair all over. Rich jeans. And the father says, I don't think he can ever keep you happy. She says, no, but I believe he can keep me happy. He says, okay, go to hell, get married to him, you'll never be happy. Father takes thin slice of a person's personality, not knowing him at all because of his conditioning, because a guitarist or a person in the music line can never keep my daughter happy. She needs to have money and support to be happy. So this is how impressions are formed, and most of them are accurate and everlasting till life gives us the third, fourth, or the fifth opportunity to erase those first impressions. Later on, probably when he meets his son-in-law, over a period of time, he might be able to erase that first impression. Say, I thought he was not good, but actually he's good. But life, is life so kind to you all the time? Is life so kind to you all the time? Life is not so kind to you all the time. Wherein